नमस्ते, आई डॉक्टर तन्मय गोस्वामी ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ गिव एकेडमी हियर टू डिस्कस अबाउट योगा एंड ज्योतिष एंड ऑल वैदिक साइंसेस. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वांट टू गिव हार्टी थैंक्स टू ऑर्गेनाइजर्स ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम हु हैज गिवन मी अ चांस टू प्रेजेंट a relationship of yoga with all Vedic science. Actually, Vedic sciences, Vedic knowledge is actually about consciousness, chitta. We are not this body. We have one consciousness. And how to improve consciousness, that is actually the aim of Vedic knowledge, Vedic sciences. So Vedic sciences is actually a tree in which trunk is consciousness, roots have four Vedas, Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda and Atharva Veda. Rig Veda is about soul, about energy. Yajur Veda is about yajna, sense power, giving nervous system energy, giving energy to nervous system, indriyas, all senses. Samaveda is all about music, prayers, is giving power to mind. And Atharva Veda is Tantra, is about physical body. So four Vedas are actually aimed on soul, senses, mind and physical body, matter. These are the roots, and this consciousness is a trunk and it gives various branches. One is yoga, one is Ayurveda, Vastu, Jyotishya, music, mantras, Tantra Shastra, Niti Shastra. They all are interconnected actually, because they all are aimed to improve internal strength, which is internal consciousness. Now, what is yoga? Yogas tu chitta vritti nirodha. Chitta is actually, it's a state of mind and soul within the body, which is carrying all experiences of past life in seed form. So this past knowledge, past experiences of pain and happiness is present in this seed form in our within us. And aim is to get rid of this past pains and make a fresh beginning. So yoga chitta vritti nirodha, it is to stop instincts of past pains over our mind. When you do asanas, pranayama, dhyana, meditation, samadhi, actually step by step you try to conquer your consciousness and remove this painful experiences from smriti. Actually, you can do it better if you can take help of other Vedic branches. They all are complementary to each other. To improve this chitta, Jyotishya tells about how to improve our consciousness and know your journey of life. In this journey of life, which type of past related consciousness can come up, so that with the help of yoga and Ayurveda, one can correct it. Similarly about Ayurveda. Ayurveda actually helps to balancing the energies, dosha dhatu samyatva, to rejuvenate, to detox the body, so that we can get better benefits of yoga, means better benefit of removing the pains of karmas of past. If you see, if you observe, my dear friends, in a very subtle way, you will find that in yoga, Jyotish is very deeply involved. most important asanas which are practices by yogis, by Hatha Yoga Pradipika and by all other, even by Patanjali. Main yoga asanas which are practiced are Surya Namaskara and Chandra Namaskara. If you say in other language, Sun Salutation and Moon Salutation. From where these words are coming up? Sun Salutation, Moon Salutation, the Sun and Moon are the basis of Jyotishya. When you do Anuloma Viloma Pranayama, we take breathing in, inhale and exhale through Chandra Nadi and Surya Nadi. Right Nadi is called as Surya Nadi, Pingala. Left Nadi is called as Ida, Chandra Nadi. Why the names have given Chandra and Surya Nadis? Chakras, a very important part of Tantric Yoga. Muladhara Chakra. Jyotishya has given reference that is governed by Shani. Swadhisthana Chakra, which is about neurohormones. Ayurveda also has given about chakra amazing explanation like yoga. They all are very much intermingled. You can't separate them. You know, it's like separating body from mind and soul. Swadhisthana Chakra, which is important chakra for yogis, to activate it, it's governed by moon. Muladhara Chakra and Swadhisthana Chakra I explained. Now Manipura Chakra, which is Agni Sthana, place of fire according to Ayurveda. According to Jyotishya, it's a place governed by Mars. Anahata Chakra, which is in chest Uras, which is controlled by correction of lymphatic system, Rasadhatu. By Ayurveda, Jyotishya says it is controlled by Mercury planet. Vishuddhi Chakra, a chakra of power of speech, is governed by Jupiter. Ajna Chakra, which you have seen in India, women used to cover by Bindi. Red color kumkuma is put in this Ajna Chakra. This is a particular herbal mineral powder. If you apply, it won't let pituitary to get the imbalance and disturbances. So this Ajna Chakra is for Shukra. And Sahasrara Chakra is governed by, controlled by Surya, Ravi. You see, all these chakras have a relationship with planets. Ida and Pingala Nadi, Surya and Chandra Nadi, they have a connection with Jyotishya planets, cosmic connection. Sun Salutation has a cosmic connection. Chandra Namaskara, Moon Salutation has a cosmic connection. As I said before, if you observe Sun Salutation, my dear friend, 12 zodiacs are there and there are 12 poses in Sun Salutation. Aquarius, when you start, that is a pranama pose, praying pose. Second is, so first and the 12th, both are pranama pose, prayer pose, and both are for Shani, Kumbha and Makara, Aquarius and Capricorn. Second asana in Sun Salutation, second and 11th. So second is Pisces and 11th house is Sagittarius. This is raised arm pose. When you take, you put your body in extension back. Hasta Uttanasana. Third set is for Aries and Scorpio, which is governed by Mars. Hasta Padasana, forward bending. Fourth, same asana is for Taurus and Libra, which is Venus oriented zodiacs. Ashva Sanchalana Asana, where you move your body like a horse, lunge pose. Fifth step is for Gemini and Virgo, both are governed by Mercury, is Chaturanga Asana. Fifth step and eighth step are Gemini and Virgo, both are governed by Mercury, that is Chaturanga Dandasana, V-shaped body. And then comes very special for Cancer, sixth pose, and for Leo, seventh pose. The sixth pose for Cancer is Ashtangasana, eight limb asana, which is only one. And then seventh pose is Bhujangasana, cobra pose. And then again it's same repetition. Actually, according to your horoscope, you can plan which step of sun salutation has to be given more emphasis. It's a further deep level. I have done this research in my research work. More than 100 cases got benefited by that. Thanks to Corona time, where we got the chance to work on bringing academic work on this. You see, about Chandra Namaskara, moon salutation. Moon cycle is not 30 days, it's a 28 days cycle. It has two paksha, from new moon till full moon 14 days, then from full moon to new moon 14 days, and moon salutation has 14 steps. And there is a wonderful balancing in Ardhachandrasana, which is only addition along immediately after Ashwasanchalanasana. So one thing is sure, by seeing one person's horoscope, we can tell in sun salutation which step has to be repeated, has to be given more emphasis. To correct your moon condition, to correct your chitta, sun, after sun salutation, moon salutation is very important. There also a lot of work can be explained, which I am starting this course on Yoga and Jyotishya, Yoga and Ayurveda, and Jyotishya and Ayurveda very soon. In Ida and Pingala, Surya and Chandra Nadi, Moon and Sun Nadi, during Pranayama, we can see horoscope and we can plan Pranayama according to that. We can see horoscope and we can plan chakras according to that. And we can plan meditation according to that. My dear friends, before discarding any theory or accepting any theory, we need research work. And that is my job. I am very happy that I got an opportunity. Thanks to you all, my friends, especially Felix, Anna, Sergey, everyone, that you gave me a chance to share this great knowledge with happiness. Thank you.